I know you can do better.
You are clapping for me, that's too much. But if you are clapping for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the only potentate, you can certainly do better. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let's worship God together. Let's rise as we give it to Him.
Holy are you, Lord, all creation, 'cause you love.
Makapaka santae, lipo koseka ya ba 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 ba.
Your majesty, awesome God, how great thou art. You are God, my eye of me, rock, we stand in
time.
Holy are you, Lord,
creation,
'cause you love,
holy
is your name. Your holy name, oh, yeah, we bow and worship you,
Lord, we bow. Let's go ahead and worship the King of Kings. Let's go ahead and worship the Lord of Lords, the only God who can bring us to another season of youth alive. Let's magnify the name of our Father. Let's give Him praise. Let's lift Him high. Let's say thank you, Father. Psalm 92 verse 1 says, it is good to give thanks to the Lord. Let's exalt His name. Let's thank Him for great things He has proposed even to do this season, this week, in our midst. Let's give Him adoration. Let's exalt the name of our Father. Baba, we worship you. Daddy, we lift you high. Let's ask, Lord, let it please you to accomplish the fullness of your counsel this week, this day, this time, this season, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, accomplish your purpose in our midst. Through this youth alive, let the fullness of your counsel be done, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, go ahead, tell Him, Father, let it please you to accomplish your purpose, the fullness of your purpose, in the name of Jesus. Ask Him to send His word, ask Him to visit you, ask Him to give you a divine encounter even today, in the name of Jesus. Ask him to visit you personally. To visit your home, visit your life, visit your family. Thank you, Father. We worship you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Daddy, we thank you. Daddy, we bless you. Daddy, we reference you. Thank you for bringing us to another season of youth alive. What a great God you are. Have your way. As we kickstart this year's youth alive today, Lord, start with us. Open the heavens. Glorify your holy name. Lord, let your word come unhindered, unfettered. In the name of Jesus, bless every life under the sound of my voice today, Lord. Glorify your name, Daddy. In Jesus' awesome name, we have prayed. Please be seated. I want to welcome us to another season of Youth Alive. I pray you will not miss your visitation in the name of Jesus. Book of 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 to 5, that was read to us earlier. So ever, 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 to 5. So, for whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. This morning, I have the mandate to speak to us about born to overcome. Can you please say it to somebody by your side? Can you repeat to another fellow on your right or on your left? Say, born to overcome. The word of God tells us that everyone, I repeat, everyone who is born of God overcomes the world. And that includes you. What a good news. It does not matter what you are going through as we speak. It does not matter your experience in our nation called Nigeria. You have been born to overcome. That's a good news. Isn't it a good news? But that is the reality of the situation on hand. Everyone that is born of God has been born to overcome. No matter what you are passing through, no matter your present circumstances, that is the mind of God for you and me. But unfortunately, many believers live below God's original expectation, God's original intent for their lives. Many times we settle for weaknesses of self, instead of depending on the strength of Christ. We settle for defeats when God desires. He always calls us to triumph. We settle for failure when God's good pleasure is to see us succeed. We settle for a prison life, when God has already provided the freedom. We settle for worldliness when God's desire and design is that we'll be Christ-like-mindedness. We'll be Christ-like-minded. I challenge you this morning that dare to break the status quo. Dare to break the status quo Christianity. Be an overcomer. God intended you to be. First John chapter 5, verse 1, we read, says, you are born of God. You are born of what? Of God. Second Peter chapter 1 verse 4 says, you are partaker of the divine nature, which enable you to escape the moral decay that is in this world. So what the word of God is saying, in other words, is that as long as you are born of God, you will overcome. Oh, I want you to be a prophet to somebody. Tell your neighbor, you will overcome. No matter what you are going through, no matter that challenge of your health, no matter that challenge in your workplace, you will overcome. I say you will overcome in the name of Jesus. What the concept means is that when the word of God is saying we are overcomer, it's saying we will overcome the devil, we overcome temptations, we overcome trials and persecutions, we overcome sicknesses, affliction, poverty, lack, bad governance, adversity, whatever the name, even lust, illicit drugs, masturbation, alcohol, depression, name it, everything that is of bad report. The mind of God says, as soon as you realize who you are, the identity, and you click to it, you believe God, and you follow God, you will overcome. I pray this morning, you will overcome in the name of Jesus. To summarize John's exposition, he's saying that overcoming the world means we overcome the system of evil in this world and rebellion against God. That's why he reiterated the original sins. 1 John chapter 2 verse 15 to 17. 1 John chapter 2 verse 15 to 17. Say, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, what's in the world? Three major things. One, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but it's of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. So when we're talking about being an overcomer, you must overcome these three things. Every other thing will fall in line. The original sin, right from the days of Adam till now. The trouble, the sin, the temptation, they are just three. Under which the devil want to turn, he want to take you away, want to tell you that you are not an overcomer. But he has missed it. Because you are here this morning, he said he has failed. Oh, you did not hear me. I said devil has failed over your life. When we talk about the lust of the flesh, you must not love pleasure more than God, more than the things of God. You must not seek continually to want to gratify the pleasure, you know, or pleasure your body, wanting to satisfy the desire of the flesh all the time. That's the lust of the flesh. Lust of the eye, of the eyes, describes somebody who is captivated by the outward show of materialism, physical beauty, or desire for stuffs generally. That's not godly. It robs off heavenly mindedness when we focus our attention on things of this world alone. When we recklessly pursue the tangible, the visibles, and all we can easily, you know, that can make us to easily forget faith. Then the pride of life, when we boast about what one does, and you know, for a living, for example, and the abundance of the things one has because of it. I have a big mansion, I have a big car, I am so. No. Why? 1 John chapter 4 verse 3 to to 4. 1 John chapter 4 verse 3 to 4 says, and every spirit that confesseth not Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now is already in the world. But ye are of God, little children. Use, the Lord is saying, you are of God. And you have overcome them. All the desires of the flesh, all, you know, Galatians chapter 5 verse 19 tells us, all those things mentioned, he's saying, you have overcome them. Because greater is one in you, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You are free from his control today in the name of Jesus. Listen, youths. 1 John chapter 2, verse 13 to 14. He said, I write to you, young men, young women, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you, little children, because you have known the Father. I have written unto you, fathers, because you have known him, that is from the beginning. I have written unto you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abideth in you, and ye have overcome the wicked one. May you overcome today in the name of Jesus. I speak into your life, you will overcome the wicked one. Because you are born of God, I pray you will never live below God's expectation. God, what God has created you to be in the name of Jesus. Peradventure there is somebody under the sound of my voice, you've lost your identity as an overcomer. I pray today, let that be a discovery. Let that be a recovery. Today, now, in the name of Jesus, of who you are in Christ, of whom God has created you to be, in the name of Jesus. Sometimes an individual can overcome in an area and not be overcome in another area. But when you embrace Christ completely, when you seek him completely, you will overcome. You will have victory. What it means that you will have victory over, you will subdue, you will have dominion, you have a mastery over the devil and his courts, and over the world in the name of Jesus. What the Lord is saying in that word is that you are an overcomer. I trust that you will believe God this morning. He said you are an overcomer because you have been born to overcome. God designed you to be an overcomer. That is your true identity. You may not feel it, you may not see it. Feelings may change, but when you hold on to the word of God, I put it to you this morning, you are an overcomer. Irrespective of your circumstance, irrespective of what you may be feeling, because God says so, and God cannot lie. I say God cannot lie. You are seated with him in the heavenly places, in a position of triumph, in a position of authority, in a position of victory. Hallelujah! What makes a man to overcome? When he overcomes sin. Principally, I told you three principal sins and all the offshoots. To be an overcomer, one, you must what? Overcome sin. 1 John chapter 3 verse 9. He said, for whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. I don't know if it's in your Bible, sir. You saw it. Please open your Bible. We are saying, what can make a man to be an overcomer? We are talking about born to overcome. Number one principal way to overcome is what? To be born of God. And when you are born of God, you do not commit sin. Why? For his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. If you claim you are a child of God and you are still living in secret sin, something is wrong with you. Hello, somebody. 1 John chapter 5 verse 18 says, we know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and the wicked one toucheth him not. Romans chapter 6 verse 14 says, Romans 6:14 says, for sin shall not have dominion over you, for ye are not under the law but under grace. Meaning that the moment you are born again, you have given your life to Jesus, you don't live a life of sin. That's what makes you an overcomer, dear sister. That's what makes you an overcomer, dear brother. That's what makes you an overcomer, mommies and daddies in the house. You can never claim, you cannot claim to be an overcomer when you still indulge in sin. You cannot claim to be an overcomer when you still go behind and you take drugs. You still watch pornography. You still masturbate. You still go to disco. I don't know what they call it these days. I didn't hear you. Oh, club. Thank you very much. They are all around us today. Everywhere you go. In fact, they don't pretend. They will bring a big board, naked girls, to attract them. They call it all manner of name to glamorize and make it look fanciful. You can never claim to be an overcomer. Sin must not have dominion over your life. Why? Because the seed of God is in you. You cannot sin again. If you are still living a life of sin, please come and do deliverance. To be an overcomer, one, you must overcome sin. Number two, you have to overcome Satan and his demons and his hosts. Luke chapter 10 verse 19. Luke 10:19. The word of God says, and Jesus said, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. To be an overcomer. And they said there's a girl possessed in your hostel and you are running away. You are not there yet. You should just tell them, let them bring the girl. Let them bring the boy. Whoever. Brethren, let us pray. That is the attitude of an overcomer. Why? You've been given power to tread upon serpents, to overcome Satan, to overcome demons, to overcome everything that is, you know, unclean, familiar spirits, everything that does not glorify God, whatever name they are called. As long as you remain in the Lord, there's a power of God upon your life. You are a moving altar. You have been born of God. Satan should see you and flee. Revelation 12 verse 11 says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto death. If you claim to be a child of God, that is who you are. Just sharing your life, your conduct among your brethren. He that is possessed, he that is unclean, will move away from you because he know he will be exposed. That's the truth. You don't even need to say in Jesus' name or do continuous night vigil. Of course, we will do that. But your life, your testimonies, your conduct should be such that unclean spirits, whether in the house, on the road, in the bus, will leave. I had a testimony of a sister. She was to travel and she was in the bus. The bus delayed, tarried before taking off. And another person in the vehicle. They have not prayed. They have not, she has not said a word. But the woman, because she's possessed, she wanted to carry out an operation. She became uncomfortable. And she said, no, I'm not going again. You want to go, you can't go, le sokale. Milomo. She sensed a power. When the lady got to the car, just pleaded the blood of Jesus. Father, thank you for this journey. Thank you for everyone that will travel with me. Thank you for the road. I soak everybody here in the blood of Jesus. And she was praying in tongues, quietly. Oh yeah, oh yeah, Lagos, Lagos. But she was the principality that was running the vehicle, sent as a higher power. And she gave way. She went, she came, she went, and she was shouting outside. She was pointing to the boss. Why? A higher power. You carry the higher power. I said you carry the higher power. She dropped from the vehicle. She didn't go with them. And people were just, she was just the daughter of Christ. Daughter of Zion was just smiling. But thank God. If not, she would have, who knows what she planned. Maybe I've had an accident or something, but there was a higher power in the vehicle. What kind of power are you carrying? You are an overcomer. You are carrying the presence of God. You are a Holy Ghost carrier. Number three, when you overcome everything that opposes the purpose of God for your life and His kingdom. God has plans and purposes. When we key into it and you pursue it, the whole world around will know you are an overcomer. Because the devil will always want to oppose, hinder, and distract us from fulfilling his purpose. But he will not succeed over your life in the name of Jesus. An overcomer, somebody who is overcome, who was born to overcome, we always seek to do the purpose of God. Win souls. Do service. Belong to a service department. Serve the Lord. Do it with the whole of your heart. Is there a reward for an overcomer? Certainly. Revelation told us 6 of them. And many more, of course. Whether here, and in the life after, in eternity, there are rewards for overcomers. Revelation chapter 2 verse 7 says, "He will give them to eat from the tree of life." Oh, wonderful. Revelation 2 7. Revelation 2 17 says, "Hidden manna and wise to and a new name will be given unto overcomers." Revelation 2 11 says, "They will not be hurt by the second death." Revelation 2, 26 to 28 says, "He will give them power over the nations." I just told you it's simple, quiet. Powers over the nations. Revelation 3, 5 says, "He will give them white garments. He will write their names in the book of life and confess their name before his Father in heaven." Finally, reward of an overcomer, Revelation 3:21 said, "They will sit with me on my throne." I don't know how many of us want to sit with Jesus on his throne. What a great reward. How do we overcome? The scripture we read made it clear. Talked about faith, talked about believing. Number one, he said, even our faith. 1 John chapter 5, verse 4. Say, whatever is born of God, whosoever is born of God, Deji that is born of God, Tunde that is born of God, will overcome the world. And this is the victory that overcome the world. Even, so in other words, we need faith. Hebrew 11 verse 6 says, "But without faith it is impossible to please him, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." We must learn to walk by faith, not by sight. Operate the principles of faith. Why? Many times, the victory God has given unto you, they will not be clear. Because we are not walking by sight. We must walk by faith. We must walk with Him. But when you persist, when you continue, it will show. Faith is not saying thy will be done and not doing anything about it. Just confess and go to sleep. It's not enough. Genuine faith discerns the will of God and presses through, overcoming every obstacle to see it accomplished. God in heaven expresses his will and he looks to his people on earth to execute it. God's will is that all men be saved, for example, you know. But he's looking up to you and I to go out and do operation double portion. He's expecting us as we go to our places of work and be a star, that our conduct, our life, we draw people to him. Yes, it's his will to have all men saved, but all men will not be saved until we go out, until you do something, until I do something. That's faith and work. And works, you must join them together. So we must learn how to put your faith to work. We must bring the truth of God's word into the realm of daily experience. Believe God that as you go, there's a God factor in that situation and follow on to God to the end. That's faith. Hear him, believe him, and do what he says, and he will show himself. A sister came some years ago now. She was afflicted. And she could feel insects walking on her body from the head to the, she tried everything. While she was going through that, she was stagnated in life. The devil, you know, kept telling her, you will never overcome, you will never be delivered, you will never amount to anything. But she held on to her faith. One day she came on a Sunday like this. Because that thing will come and go. But she did not give up. She made up her mind. She couldn't see it. There's trouble in the world. And she narrated the story. And thank God, that moment, that thing came again. She said, something will move from the head to the toe and come. And she couldn't see. And she would, as if she was trying to kill a mosquito or a cockroach. She couldn't see. But that day, God gave her victory because she did not give up. She held on to her faith that this thing, I will overcome you. As we're praying, that something started again from her leg and it started to her head. All of a sudden, she started sneezing and something came as if coming to the nose like this and she started sneezing. And that's how the invisible insect went out of her body. After that incident, she completed her PhD, she got a job, so many things happened. She became an overcomer. She did not give up. I don't know in that area you have been giving up. Maybe, but long she faculty, she really gone here. No, you are an overcomer. The second thing you must do to be an overcomer, we said one, how do you overcome? By faith. Demonstrate your faith. If your faith is low, ask God to increase your faith. Number two, you must have overcomer mentality. That scripture, 1 John chapter 5, says you must believe. It's critical. Believe the word of God. John chapter 16, verse 33 says, In the word, you will see tribulation. You will have tribulation, but we can live as overcomer because Jesus has paved the way for us to live as one, just as he did. John 16:33. So he has spoken ahead, he has sent his word ahead. There will be tribulation, the economy will be bad. This will happen, that will happen. But hold on to his word. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 14 is another word, another promise. He has promised to cause us to triumph always. That's the word of God concerning you, concerning me. And these words are forever settled in heaven. and the scriptures cannot be broken. It will come to pass concerning you. It will come to pass concerning me. In the name of Jesus. Number three, to be an overcomer, you must learn how to fight. This is the last one I'm taking, so we can go into prayer. What did I say? That you have been born to overcome does not mean things will happen. You must make it happen. You must learn how to fight, a fight of faith. That you are born an overcomer does not give you a license to go to bed. James chapter 4 verse 7 says, submit yourself therefore to God, not to man, not to pastor. Thank God for pastors, I'm one of them. But the word of God is saying, submit yourself to who? Oh, you are not here again. Are you sure you are still following me? Submit yourself to who? And what? Resist the devil, and he will flee. Who will do the resisting? Over that matter, sickness, enough is enough. Barrenness, enough is enough. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 11 verse 12, it says, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. You must learn how to what? Fight. You must resist that situation that is contrary. This is not the word of God concerning me. Doctor gives you a prescription, and you know, and you know, and you know. He said, not me, sir. I reject it. Settle it in your mind. That you are not good, you are not going to, you will not grieve for anybody. You will not allow the enemy war to give you a labor that is not your own. You must resist adverse situation. You must take steps. Don't just say it with mouth. Take steps. Fast, pray, seek the face of the Lord. Father, what are you saying over this matter? This is not your counsel. This is not your word for me. Your word says, I will be the top. I will not be beneath. You are on the same spot for years. No promotion. You are saying you are a Christian. You are carrying a Bible. When I was a manager, I was a bank. I was working in the bank. Every day I go to the office. I say, God, this is not my hand. You have something better for me. Give me a picture. I didn't receive anything for a long time. I persisted. Show me. Even that place, there was a move. When I got to the next point of call, I started crying to him again. Father, you said the path of a righteous man is like a shining light, oh, it shining brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. This is not my rest. I'm going somewhere. I made me an HOD almost immediately. I said, Father, thank you for this. I know there is something better. And a revelation came. The office, I knew, this is better. Thank God. For two years or thereabout, that dream didn't come to pass. I became a dean. Well before I became an HOD, I saw the revelation. And I knew. I said, Father, thank you. I know there is something you are saying. HOD is not what I saw. But thank God for God. I took it. I rejoiced. I followed God. After I became acting dean, I became dean. When I became dean, I started talking to God. I know this is not my hand. There is a better place. I was elected a governing council, member of the government of my university. I said, Father, thank you. But this is not... This is not. There is a higher ground for you. There is a better place for you. You are an overcomer through Christ Jesus. We had the story. Baba Omolayin shared the story of a woman, a child of God, a billionaire. Please listen to this story as we round up, because we are going to take some prayer points. She flew to meet Baba in London. Many of us must have heard. Baba shared a part of it with us about two, three glory conferences away. She was rich. She must still be rich. She has a factory in Bashita, and the factory closed down. Why? The people, the natives, the traditional leaders, the obas, said, you must come and do sacrifice. And the woman said, I am a child of God. I won't do any sacrifice. Said, you are from Ondo. We are the owner of this Kogi. Whatever we tell the land is what the land will do. She said, okay. They had to close down the factory. But thank God for God. Somebody in London, when Baba was invited, and told him, there's a woman that will benefit from your ministration, if only you will permit. Baba said, why not? And the crusade was to end that weekend. They invited the woman. She flew to London. When Baba heard the story, he said, don't worry, go and wait for me. I know Bashita. Bashita is just 1 hour's drive from Ilorin. The woman said, no, I will provide an helicopter to carry you from Ilorin to Bashita. Baba said, if you carry me with helicopter, the following day when I return, people will line up in his house asking for... Baba said, don't worry, I will come. But before Baba went, because of the tenacity and the doggedness of this woman of God, she's a child of God, she made up her mind. She was not going to compromise. Baba sent people ahead, 2 pastors. Go and locate the Oju boss in that town and desecrate them. Don't come out in the day, only in the night. Go out. Violate the demons, the altars in that town. 3 days, he got somebody, a pastor friend, and they stayed, those 2 pastors stayed with him. The 3rd day, Baba arrived and went and, you know, spoke some things. He removed his shoe, and then the sugar cane was as tall as himself, but they dried up. Acres. And Baba, the woman has dug drainage almost 25 miles from the River Niger to the place. Despite that, because of the evil words spoken to the farm, the sugar cane all dried up. Following what those pastors had done to prepare the ground, Baba arrived, removed his shoe, entered into the farm, and spoke. And within a month, all the sugar cane turned green again. Life of an overcomer. She did not agree. Don't think you must compromise to be an overcomer. The woman made up her mind, I will not do any sacrifice to any evil God, because I am a child of God. You must identify the gods behind your trouble, beyond your matter. Sometimes people don't become overcomers because of powers of their father's houses, powers in their villages. Some will labor and labor and labor. I'm talking to the youth this morning. Listen, you must not live the life of your parents. You must do better. Trouble that confronted us and defeated your parents will not defeat you. That's what Baba did. He sent those people ahead. You remember when Moses was to overcome in Egypt and deliver the children of God, what did he do? God used him to defeat the gods of the land. I think Exodus chapter 12, verse 12, if you look at it, God was saying, he did not defeat it. Many of the trouble we are having as a professor, as a manager, as an administrator, we will be overcome in one area, and another area we were underdog. That will stop from today. When God was to deliver the children of Israel, the Bible said, and God dealt with the gods of the land. Okay? For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night. Many of the time you will do it in the night. Those people did not come out in the day, which Baba sent. They went in the middle of the night. And I will smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast, and against all the gods. Did Moses overcome or not? I can't hear you. You will overcome. Do spiritual mapping of your family, of your village. I have to do that sometime. Maybe I need to bring it alive. I bring to relate it sometime not too long ago. I went with a pastor friend to my village. We left here around 6 and we got there around 9 in the night. And we spoke some things. We challenged the girls. We went to some Ojubos and we violated them. We went in the middle of the night with a pastor friend. After that, you have started, you've heard a little about my testimony. Nothing has happened yet. We are just starting. In the night, we went throughout the night, we prayed. We went to a particular river, just opposite my family house, and we told the power, the gods that is controlling the water, because they don't eat the fish. And we said so many scriptures. We went to the market and said, this place will violate you today. You must identify those gods and deal with them for you to overcome. It's not enough to carry big Bibles. It's time to identify and recognize your identity in Christ Jesus. Then you will become an overcomer. I said you will become an overcomer. Yeah. You are under the sound of my voice. You are not giving your life to Jesus. You have not started. Let's pray for you now. Before we take some prayer, violent prayer, brutal prayers. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust in his presence daily. I surrender all. You are here to fully give your life to Jesus. Don't become the meat for the devil. Put your right hand on your chest as I pray with you. That Lord, I want to be an overcomer. Accept me. I give my life unto you. Just put your right hand on your chest as I pray with you. You must not miss this opportunity. Say, Lord, I know I am a sinner. Have mercy upon me. I confess my sins. Every sin I've ever committed, Lord, forgive me. The blood you shed on the cross of Calvary, let it wash away my sins. From today, Lord, give me power not to sin again. Is anybody saying the prayer? Please say with the whole of your heart. Heaven is waiting. Heaven is watching. Say, Lord, come into my life. Today I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. I don't want to live a life of a life below par, below what you have proposed for me. From today, Lord, give me power to know you, power to serve you. Thank you, everlasting Father. Yes, dear brother, can see you. Heaven can see you. Say the prayers. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Father, I pray for your son, and as many that have said the sinner's prayer, you will have mercy. You will accept them. The blood you shed on the cross of Calvary, let it wash away their sins in Jesus' name. From today, Lord, give them power to live for you. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Shall we rise as we take these three prayers? Lamentation chapter 3, verse 22 to 23. Lamentation chapter 3, verse 22 to 23. Say, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Father, thank you for the arrival of this new month. Thank you for arrival of fresh breath, fresh strength, fresh life, fresh faithfulness and mercies. Daddy be glorified, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray. Father, thank you for the arrival of this new month, for this new season in the name of Jesus. Oh God, thank you for youth alive. Thank you for this new season. Thank you, Father, for fresh strength, for fresh grace, fresh unction from your presence in the name of Jesus. That they be glorified, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, in Jesus' precious name we pray. 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 to 5. 1 John 5, verse 4 to 5. Say, for whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Who is he that overcometh the world? But he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God. You're going to pray. Father, I am born of you. I am born of God. Therefore, I receive faith to be an overcomer in the battles of my life, today and forever, in the name of Jesus. Father, I am born of you. I am born of God. Therefore, I receive faith, I receive strength, I receive grace to be an overcomer in the battles of my life, in the name of Jesus, from today and henceforth. Thank you, Father, because I am born of you. I am born of God. Therefore, I receive faith, I receive strength, I receive power to be an overcomer in all my battles. Everywhere I go, I receive strength, I receive grace, I receive enablement to be an overcomer in the name of Jesus. Makasatayaba, rekasetelebo, rikasetelebo kuri, rakasata lebo kuri, kasanta, leke lebo huri, rekaka kaka li, lintapo, rekasata ye. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. The last prayer, Exodus chapter 12, verse 12 to 13. Exodus 12, verse 12 to 13. He said, for I will pass through the land of Egypt this night, and I will smite all the firstborn of the land of Egypt, both man and beast, and against all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgment. I am the Lord, and the blood shall be to you a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you, while I smite the land of Egypt. I want you to pray. Father, I invoke the power in the blood of the Lamb. Father, I invoke the power in the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Jesus, against all the gods of my father's house, all the powers of my father's house, all powers behind my troubles, in the name of Jesus. Every power limiting my life to be an overcomer, I overcome you today. I invoke the blood of Jesus. I invoke the power and the blood of the Lamb to overcome every evil god, every evil power of my father's house, in the name of Jesus. You ordain me to be an overcomer. Let my true identity appear now. Let my real self show up now. I am an overcomer. I am not a failure. I am not a weakling. I am not barren. In the name of Jesus, I receive power in the blood of Jesus. I invoke the power in the name of Jesus to overcome every evil alliance, every power militating against my life, against my destiny. In the name of Jesus, I overcome sickness, I overcome adversity, I overcome every evil. In the name of Jesus, I am an overcomer in Christ. I will overcome. In the name of Jesus. Father, let my true identity appear now. Let my true self show up now. Let my real identity manifest today, in the name of Jesus. Because I'm an overcomer, I am not a failure, I am not a weakling. In the name of Jesus, I will manifest, I will triumph, I will exert, I will break forth, despite the situation, no matter the environment, because the seed of Christ is in me. The seed of God is upon my life. In the name of Jesus, makose kelebo rikasata yerikasakaya maragadagadagadagada maragadagadagadagadagada. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. I don't know that thing in your own life. You're going to face it. I told you I visited my home of birth and we confronted the gods. I saw some hand. I saw some things. I don't know that thing you know or you have had. You're going to pray. This time is very, we're going to pray in tongue now. You're going to identify that challenge. Yours could be health. Yours could be finance. Yours could be a spirit of average. Yours could just be you are pursuing that matter. Somehow it will not just click. For some, amubani, so you're going to pray in the spirit. But before you pray, identify a particular thing, a particular challenge, a particular problem. It could be in the family. You may not even have experienced it yet. You may not have even noticed, but you know something is just right. Now is the day. We are rounding up now. We are rounding up. Just talk to God. This power, or whatever power is behind this challenge, this problem. For a family, it could be high blood pressure running through the family. For some, it's diabetes. For some, they cannot build their own house. They are living in rented apartments. You just look at it. Uncles, they are never there. They will build, they will not complete. I want you to lift your hand to God this hour. I want you to talk to the Lord. Enough is enough. You caused me to be born as an overcomer. That's who I am. Ogun yi eni lo ma wole je wole leni oluwa ogun aye mi je wole ogun aye mi ogun ebi mi je wole because there is power in the blood of Jesus. I will overcome you. This challenge, this battle, this trouble in a family, the male sons are bedwetting and you know it. You are not doing anything about it. In some family, it's late marriage and it's affecting you now. You can confront the God, the power behind that trouble. You know the story. Just look into your family history and confront that God in the name of Jesus. Confront that power. By the power in the blood of Jesus, they will submit. They will bow. The Bible says as soon as they hear me, they will obey me. It says strangers will fade out of their close places. Every close place they have been hiding in your loins, in your blood, in your family house, command them to bow, command them to give up. By the authority in the blood of Jesus, we subdue them now. We subdue them now in the name of Jesus. Gbogbo agbara ti awa nu Jesu ti akori ton ba ofira mo ba won wi ni oni mo ba won wi ni oruko Jesu woni ko ma wole woni ko ma wole nipa agbara ije odu agutan a ba won wi. As someone the ofo, gbogbo agbara ajeji ninu abi re ninu le baba re mo ba won wi mo ni ko wole. The anointing Lord Jesus breaks the yoke by the Holy Ghost and power. Just as the prophet foretold, this is the day of a lattering. God is moving in his powers again. By the anointing, Jesus breaks the yoke. By the anointing, Lord Jesus breaks the yoke. The Holy Ghost and power, just as the prophet foretold. This is the day of a lattering. God is moving in his power again. By the anointing, Jesus breaks the yoke. It's not by power.
It's not by power.
It's not by.
Jesus' name is one.
By the reason of anointing upon this service, I break that yoke over your life, over your family, in the name of Jesus. The word of God says, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, so that the King of glory may come in. Say, who is this King of glory? The Lord strong, the Lord mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your head, every evil head, every evil gate, every evil chain holding the people of God. Break now in the name of Jesus. Receive your liberty. Receive your deliverance. Receive your lifting. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. I break that yoke over your life, over your family, over your head. Be delivered now in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we thank you. I lift up the blood of Jesus over that life. You are having an issue with blood and it runs in the family. By the authority of the living God, that hold, I ask, Lord, visit the foundation of that problem, the foundation of that trouble, the foundation of that battle. The word of God, you cause this world to cease to the end. Lord, let there be a divine intervention in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we thank you. Somebody, you are contending with a strange voice. That strange voice has been seeking strange things into your life. For example, he's saying, you are a nobody. You will fail. You will not amount to anything. This morning, I lift up the blood of Jesus that speaks better things than the blood of Abel to silence that evil voice. At some time, it's aimed, kill yourself. You know yourself, you don't have to come out. This morning, by the authority and the mercy of God, I silence that evil voice. There's another person, each time you want to go forward, you want to have a breakthrough, or something big, something praiseworthy, a revelation from the pit of hell comes, and it snatched that something away. It has happened again and again and again. Each time you want to have a breakthrough, you will see yourself in the dream and that something is stolen from you. I lift up the blood of Jesus. I lift up the banner in the name of Jesus. That power behind that evil dream, I command it to die. To die. Anytime he attempts to visit you again, the thunder of heaven will strike it. From this service, you are delivered. Amen. You will see it no more. Amen. Daddy, we thank you for answered prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.